Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Sophie Delaunay, the Executive Director of MSF in the US. To start this afternoon sessions, it is my honor to introduce the next speaker. He wanted to join us in person, but since he could not, he graciously sent us a videotaped address. Dr. Jim Yong Kim is the president of the World Bank Group, a physician and anthropologist. Dr. Kim has dedicated himself to global development for more than two decades. Before joining the World Bank, Kim served as president of Dartmouth College and held professorships at Harvard Medical School and the Harvard School of Public Health. From 2003-2005, as director of the World Health Organization's HIV/AIDS department, Dr. Kim led the 3x5 initiative, the first ever global goal for AIDS treatment, which dramatically expanded AIDS therapy in developing countries. As co-founder of the International Medical Organization, Partners in Health, Dr. Kim contributed to the creation of the Global Green Light Committee for Multidrug Resistant TB, along with other innovative efforts to address diseases that primarily affect the poor. Today, Dr. Kim will share with us his vision about how to make health science work for the most neglected patients. Dr. Jim Yong Kim.
Hello, everyone. Let me thank my friends at MSF, the Drugs for Neglected Diseases Initiative, and the Mount Sinai School of Medicine for hosting this conference. You are meeting at a crucial time. As you know, the debate on health innovation for neglected diseases and populations has intensified. Now we have an extraordinary opportunity for taking bold action that could spur health gains in poor and marginalized communities around the globe. The goal is to lay the foundation of a health science that works for the poor. To get there, we have to work on two fronts. On the one hand, we need robust research and development mechanisms, producing new technologies for the diseases that afflict poor people. This means adequate, sustainable global research investment, as well as more open approaches to sharing research knowledge. On the other hand, we have to support countries to strengthen the delivery systems that will give poor people effective access to new drugs and technologies. Let me be frank. The current model of health innovation is failing millions of the world's poorest and most vulnerable people. Honestly acknowledging this fact must be the first step in any serious discussion. To transform the situation, we need pragmatic, evidence-driven solutions that are based on the reality of poor people's lives and a deliberate commitment to social justice. I know the depth of scientific knowledge and frontline delivery experience in this room. That's why I'm confident that you will generate evidence-based analyses and recommendations that will guide countries toward transformative solutions. In the past, we've often tended to separate the concept of health innovation from the issue of effective access for the poor. We've seen innovation as concerned primarily, sometimes exclusively, with the development of new technologies. But continuous innovation is also needed in the way we deliver services, especially to poor and vulnerable populations. This must be part of how we conceptualize and incentivize health innovation from the start. That means taking a systems perspective. Even as we search for new molecules, we must foster innovation and learning in delivery systems. This is the only way to make sure new medicines and technologies will give full benefit to the people who need them most. This is why, at the World Bank Group, we are focused on supporting countries in improving their delivery systems in health and also in education, social protection, and other development sectors. This is our added value, complementing the contributions and expertise of other partners. In the months ahead, governments will make critical policy choices that will affect all aspects of health innovation. With bold action, policymakers can ignite creativity in bench research, product development, and delivery that will transform health opportunities in poor communities. Your efforts now are vital to ensure that policymakers' choices are informed by the best evidence and analysis so that those decisions bring us closer to a science that truly works for the poor. Thank you very much.